What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're going to be talking about parametric design in Revit. Now, I like to break up parametric design into two categories. One is, you know, those fancy buildings that have all of the curvy shapes and all of that. Well, that is accomplished with parametric design. In this video, we're going to be talking about the other kind, the boring kind of parametric design. So what I'm talking about is how you can use parameters inside of Revit, how you can make your model parametric in order to aid some basic necessities when it comes to floor plan design, how to follow certain rules and regulations by implementing parameters inside of Revit. So I'm going to be explaining that on a floor plan design and how you can implement parametric design when it comes to creating your floor plan layouts. Now, before I jump into the video, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description and then also up in the cards above. There you can find all of my Revit courses. I have over 136 hours of courses, and I'm adding more each month. Also there you can find some of my customized ready-to-go Revit templates. You can find some really high quality Revit families as well as a plugin. So check it out if you're interested. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And as you can see, here I am at Revit's home screen. So I'm just going to go to new, start a new project, and for the template file I'm going to be using my architecture design template. Now, as I said, if you're interested in my templates, I'm going to be leaving a link up in the cards for that, so you can check those out. Anyways, now let's click OK and let's let Revit start up. So once we have a blank new project, let's first discuss where you can implement this parametric design for your floor plans. So I'm just going to go down to level one floor plan, and then I'm going to come in and let's place some walls. So I'm just going to go to the wall tool, go to rectangle, and then for the wall, let's use the, I don't know, the exterior type. And let's make some sort of like a house or floor plan. Okay, so now let's go here to walls, and then let's use some interior walls, and let's make something like this. So here we're going to have a corridor, and then perhaps we have a couple of rooms or so, and so on. Okay, so when it comes to designing buildings, usually you have to follow some sort of code. So for example, corridors have to have a certain width. So you want to follow that for your projects, and you don't want to make your corridors smaller than what is kind of the width of the corridor that is designated by law. Also, for example, something that is quite common here in my country, I don't know, Do they do this in your country? But for example, when you place doors, usually you give it an offset from the wall enough so you can place a kind of built-in cupboard or something like that, built-in storage there behind the door. So that's just one of the things that's common here, and then that would kind of follow some regulations of how wide that storage would be. So those, for example, are some things that you might want to create as a smart parameter, which you can then use and readjust in the future. So let me show you how that would work. So what you want to do for that is go here to the Manage tab. And so now you want to go to Global Parameters. There you can create now parameters. So I'm just going to come here to New Parameter. For the name, let's call this one the corridor width. Okay, so it's going to be a common parameter, it's going to be a length parameter, and it's going to be grouped under dimensions. I'm perfectly fine with that, so just click OK. And then for the corridor width, let's say I want it to be 160. Okay, now let's create a new one. So for this one, this is going to be the door offset. And again, just same common parameter, disciplines common, type is length, and then group under dimensions and click OK. And for this, let's say I want to use 65, and then click OK, And there we go. Okay, so once we have done this, we have these parameters which we can change at any point, but we can also assign them. So let's see how we assign these parameters. So let's place a few more doors here. So door, and then I want to place one here, and then one like that. So basically we can have these doors, and then I can come in here and go to dimension, DI is the shortcut, and then just start placing these dimensions. You will see that they have kind of interesting they're interesting dimension styles. These are the ones that come with my template. So anyways, let's just place all of these just like that. So we have these dimensions, and then also I want to add this corridor width parameter. So now if I just select all of these, so hold the control key and then select all four, I can go here to label and then add door offset. So once you click there, as you can see, it's just going to set those all up to 65. If I select this one and label it under corridor width, it's just going to go up to 60 or 160. Now at any point you can click here and you can see we have this little kind of little pencil indicating that this is a global parameter. So if you want to change this, you cannot really change it here. You have to open up that global parameter and make the change there, and then it's a, well, it's a global change, so it affects everything inside of this project, which is really cool. And then if you want to make some changes, so let's say instead of 65 I want to go with 45, you can just type it there, hit apply, and it's going to change. Here I can go with 140 and then hit apply, and it's going to change. Now apart from these, you can also create kind of dumb constraints. So it's still going to give you some control, but it's not going to be as much control. So let me show you. So let's say this is a hotel room perhaps, and then if I want to add a bathroom here, just like that. Let's say that we have some dimensions that we want to keep for this bathroom. So for this particular bathroom, I have done the design and I know that I need 218 centimeters in length, and then like this in width, I need 145, let's say. Okay, so then I could just come in here and lock these dimensions. Now this isn't really something that's going to be repeated anywhere on the project, so it doesn't really make sense for me to use a global parameter, but I still want to lock it in place. Well, now if I move any wall, as you can see, this is just going to stay the same. If I move this, it's going to move the entire corridor, and it's going to keep that bathroom there in place. So as you can see, as you add more of these constraints, your project becomes smarter, and then when you want to make those changes to it, you can make changes to the project, but only where you can make a change. You don't want to make a change and then mess something up from before, and if you don't realize it, then you get to the site, and then you're realize you made a terrible mistake, and then the house is unusable. Well, it's not unusable, but it's not as user-friendly as you would want it to be. So anyways, that's how you can use these. Now, if you're annoyed that you have a project with all of these little dimensions everywhere, obviously you don't want to see this, and when you're creating all of the project documentation, you definitely don't want to see this, at least not in this way. You want to have regular dimensions. Well, you can just make a cross selection, and let's filter this down to only dimensions. Okay, and now I can simply hit delete. Now, when you delete these, you have the option to unconstrain this. I don't want that, so I'm just going to click OK. And now we still have those constraints. So if I select this, here you can see I have this, this is locked. So see, it's locked. If I select this one, it's locked. If I select the door, we have that door offset. If I select this, I have the corridor width and all of the door offsets. So it's all still there, and then if you want to delete that dimension or whatever, you can do that. Or if you want to visualize it, you can always come down here to reveal constraints, and it's just going to show you all of those hidden dimensions that are still constraining your project. And then of course, let's uncheck this, if you make any changes now, so let's go to manage, global parameters, let's go to 180, hit apply, it's still going to affect that change. So it's still going to work. So there you go. That's how you can make your floor plans a lot smarter and make sure that you don't make any mistakes in the future, because, well, you don't want that. Okay. So anyways, I hope you have enjoyed this video. I hope you have learned something new. Please tell me in the comment section below, do you actually use something like this on your projects? Or is this something that you plan on using now that you have learned about it? Now, if you want to get access to this project file as well as all of my Revit project files, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to be including in the description of this video below and then also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.